Yeah. just like to share a few words with you about this next set of pieces that we're doing. They are four contemporary compositions by, or settings of four contemporary poets as well. And they are unified by the theme of wonder. Wonder at God's presence in the world, wonder at the creation that we find ourselves privileged to be a part of and easy to take for granted. The first piece is from the first two, rather, or from a larger collection, From Light to Light. And they're settings of a Minneapolis-based poet, Susan Paolo Sherwin. In very few words, she, through this short poem, imagines God's loving act in the creation of the earth, and also God's eternal presence with us. And this is followed by fire, a piece that is lively, energetic piece, and also from which this set music draws its name, dance, into the wonder of the earth. Next, we will move into Cloudburst by Eric Whitaker. At the heart of this piece is the mystery and the beauty, power of a thunderstorm. The poem by Octavio Paz is quite lengthy, but it's been adapted and modified here by Whitaker for this piece. The original poem really speaks to or examines the brokenness of humanity, and through the particularly through the analogy of or the symbol of burnt earth, dry earth, and the need for water, which eventually will come like rain pouring down like grace from the heavens to bring healing and wholeness to all living things. This involves a number of percussion instruments that I think do a very creative and remarkable job of imitating that the effect and majesty of this moment, the thunderstorm, or the cloudburst. The following piece, Epitaph for Moonlight, is perhaps, will be perhaps, one of the most unusual pieces of choral music that you have ever heard. It is a very unique piece. It was written in 1968 by a Canadian composer, R. Murray Schafer. And this piece was inspired by his reflection on the first moon landing, which was intended or was expected to occur the following year. Schafer thought that after we landed on the moon, after humans had traveled and stepped on its surface, that our sense of wonder at the moon would be forever changed. We would have a different relationship, a different awareness of thinking about the moon. So he wanted to capture through music, through sound, this ephemeral beauty of moonlight before anyone had ever been there. The words are most unusual, as you can see in the program. What he did was went to a class of seventh graders, and he asked them to come up with some words for moonlight in their own language. If they had to make up a language and come up with a word for moonlight, what would that be? And they came up with things like Norway, or New Yule, Shiver Glow Up. These became the lyrics of the piece. I encourage you to be open to the that the piece presents. It is, it's not for everyone, but it is certainly, I think, a unique experience. If it is not for you, I'm certain that the following piece by Morton Lawrence and Sure on the Shining Night will appeal to most everyone. It's a beautiful setting of that well-loved poem. And this poem, like many great poems, is open to many interpretations. To me, it seems that it speaks of gratitude, hope, humility. And I'm particularly drawn to the line at the end, I weep for wonder, wandering far alone, of shadows and the stars. It seems that this does not have to necessarily be a sad weeping, but you could also see it as the tear that comes to the eye, the moment when you're just in, you're fully present in awareness of this sunset or starry night, but, just aware of the awesomeness of that. Please follow along with the words and be open to the poet's attempts and the composer's as well to share some of his sense of wonder.
Thank you. I will kneel now to this temple, draw near. me.